aquí en Auto 060 y después de hablar de lo bien que está yendo las ventas de autos nuevos aquí en Estados Unidos y del mercado, cómo va a llegar otra vez al nivel de 16, 17 millones de unidades, quizá para el próximo año o quizá el 2015 a más tardar. Vamos a hablar ahora de una lista que quizá les va a sonar un poco extraña, diferente. We're switching back to English because now we're going to talk to James Resnick from Edmunds.com. How are you, James?
I'm good, and thank you for switching back to English. I wouldn't be very useful to you otherwise.
No, but thank you very much. It's a very interesting list. We were talking in the first segment of the show about how the sales in the U.S. are like exploding. I mean, we're going to reach about 16 to 17 million cars, and maybe next year or 2015. And then I come up across the internet at Edmunds.com with your list. Very interesting list, because I argue that there's no bad cars in the market anymore, but the headline, the very catchy headline from your recent post on Edmunds.com, the 17 worst cars you can buy. So can you explain a little bit the premises of the story? Because, I mean, I don't know if you agree or not, but I don't think there are really bad cars in the market anymore.
Well, there's no bad cars in the market if you consider, you know, is anything going to, it's very unlikely that something's going to catch fire on you.
Well,
or
the Tesla did. I mean, what was it that Frisker did?
Right. But if we were to, basically the idea is, if you can say this car is the best compact car or the best luxury SUV, there is going to be the one car that is just not as good as everything else.
Yeah,
I guess
the competition. So let's start a little bit to dissect this this list. Start obviously with a subcompact car, and the Smart comes out as the worst in the category for you.
Absolutely, it is cheap. It's only about $12,000 to start, but you get virtually no equipment. You don't have power steering, air conditioning, or even a radio.
So you get like an engine, four wheels, and a seat.
Yes. Pretty much. But if you put all of that stuff on it, it's more expensive than, say, a Ford Fiesta or a Chevy Sonic. Cars that have five seats and four doors and, you know, are sort of ridiculous looking.
Yeah, exactly. And then if you go to, like, the very top of the list in that model, I mean, like, the Cabrio is, like, almost 20 or more than 20, mm-hmm. which is very, very expensive comparing it to other vehicles.
Yeah, and even the idea that it would be useful in a city where you can get, you know, tight parking spots, the transmission makes it very hard to fit in those tight parking spots. It's a very jerky, slow-shifting transmission.
Yeah,
so.
It's a great car. I don't know if you're based in L.A., right, or Southern California,
yeah.
But the Car to Go company is doing really, really well, at least here in Miami where we're based. I mean, you see them everywhere, the Car2Go smart
cars. That's a shame.
Well, it's drive by minute, so it's what it is. So let's jump to another one. I mean, the compact you mentioned, the Mitsubishi Lancer, and I guess the competition has, like, sped up away from them.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, so the Lancer is a good-looking car, but it's very old now. I believe it came out in 2007, and basically everything else has been redesigned now. And it was never that great to begin with. It was never a class-leading car. But just now, it's just old. So this is one instance when, you know, this definitely isn't a bad car, but basically every other compact sedan is better.
Yeah, I mean, the competition, the industry in general is moving much, much faster now. In like, now you see cars like debuting in 1 year, and then like a year and a half later, they're making a refresh of those cars in some models, and which is pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Then you have the Dodge Avenger in the midsize sedan. I have to agree with that, and especially with the mention to the Chrysler 200. I think those two cars are like fleet cars to me.
Oh yeah, not even that's a sad day when your fleet assigns you that car. It was even worse. They overhauled it in 2011 and made it better in every way, but it's still the worst car by a mile. If you drive the Avenger and then a Ford Fusion, the new one, or even the old one, actually, you would laugh that they were supposedly...
Yeah, that's not a fair comparison, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, then the Ford Taurus. I actually don't like the Ford Taurus. I think the proportions are like the greenhouse is too small and the bottom part is like too big. I don't know. I never liked the look of it. either.
No, and it's like, this is another one where the Taurus isn't a bad car. It's just that, you know, it, everything else is better. So yeah, we just sort of, that's what we ended up with, because, you know, if you look at it, Buick LaCrosse is a great car. The new Chevy Impala is really good. Chrysler 300, Toyota Avalon, Volkswagen Stud, all better than the Taurus. So
yeah,
not a bad car.
Yeah, I recently drove the Buick LaCrosse, and I was very, very impressed, not only with the design, the interior, but the price. I mean, for about $40,000, you get a lot of car.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then the alien Lincoln division with the MKS. I mean, that car really, I mean, I completely agree with your assessment. For $50,000, you can get a lot more for, you know, the car, especially the Europeans.
I mean, if you really like it that much, you could just buy the Taurus. Buy a $40,000 Taurus and you'll save $10,000.
Yeah, I think it's a little worrisome to see what Lincoln is going on, because, I mean, they're investing a lot of money in that division, and I don't think they're going anywhere with it.
No, the MKZ is better than the MKS, but, you know, I absolutely agree.
This one really caught my attention. The Ferrari California, really?
Absolutely.
Okay, right.
The Ferrari California, is it a Ferrari? Yes. Would you like a Ferrari more than a Chrysler 200 or a Miata or something? Yes, I suppose you want to kill a Ferrari. But if you bought that Ferrari, you have bypassed so many amazing cars for the same amount of money or less, including the Ferrari Italia, for something that really, if it didn't have a Ferrari badge, is a very bulbous, ugly car.
Yeah, I understand that Ferrari was trying to attract more female buyers with that car, because it's like, I don't know, it's like more practical in a way, I guess. I don't know.
But not really. And I think women are smarter than that. I think women would rather want an Aston Martin or a Bentley Continental
The GTC.
SLS.
Yeah, absolutely. The worst coupe, and I think Nissan even agrees with you, because they discontinue it.
You're right. Yeah.
So
some of these cars are older and on the way out the door, and this is one of them.
Yeah, I guess it was, again, not being a bad car, but just sells. I mean, like, there's nothing really that is very, very attractive in that car. So Nissan agrees completely with you in that one.
Yeah, I don't understand why you would buy the Nissan Altima Coupe, because it's not that great looking, and it's less practical than the sedan.
Yeah.
And for the same money, you could have a Dodge Challenger or a Camaro, and those are far better cars.
Absolutely, yeah. Then hatchback, the worst hatchback, the Sienna IQ. I mean, that's one of those cars that you really hate it or love it. I mean, it's kind of interesting looking, I guess, but I guess there are valid points to put it in this list.
Yeah, the IQ is better than the Smart. It is better than the Smart, so we'll give you that. But it's just one of those cars that doesn't make a lot of, unless you do need to park in a very tiny parking spot, it's not that much more efficient than a regular subcompact car. And having driven that car, you feel very vulnerable.
Yeah.
Driving that amongst all the big cars that we have in the United States. It makes sense in Tokyo, not here.
Yeah, maybe in Madrid or in other cities where it's like really, really, really crowded. So we're talking to Jamie Risnowick from Edmunds.com, talking about the worst cars, the 17 worst cars you can buy. And again, like, there's not necessarily there are bad cars, but there's like much better competition. And James, we're not gonna be able to complete the list, but let's touch on a couple more before we go. The pickup truck, the Ridgeline, I think Honda is also agreeing with you in this one, because I don't think they're gonna make it for next year. I think it's coming back in 2015, I believe, right?
Yeah, the Ridgeline is actually a very interesting vehicle. There's only three small pickup trucks, so this is another one where we didn't really have a bad, or it's by default that it's the worst one. There's a lot of clever things in there, an interesting double-inch tailgate.
Yeah.
It's just not, it is an interesting concept that didn't really work. People didn't want it.
Yeah, but still, they're redesigning it, I believe, for 2015, so let's see what they come up with. And then finally, let's touch on the Escalade EXT, which, again, is in the last year of its generation. I think they're coming up with a new model pretty soon, right?
Yeah, and that's, the Escalade moment in the rap Oscar and the rapper World Sun has come to an end.
Yeah.
But it's not as bad as some of our electric vehicles that we had on our list, the Mitsubishi iNeve.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I drove that one, and I completely agree with that. I think there's a lot of much better cars, like the Fiat 500.
That's
Fiat
the worst
500.
Car on this list.
Yeah,
by the
absolutely.
Way, that is the worst car on this list.
Yeah.
Horrible, horrible car. I drove that for 5 minutes.
I know.
And I drove it one night, and that was enough.
Yeah, going back to the Escalade, I think even the thieves agree with you, because I think it was finally dropped out for the most stolen cars in the country recently. So very interesting list, James. Thank you very much. So can I guess Edmunds.com, where can our audience can find more about your reports?
Absolutely, Edmunds.com. And on Monday, we will have our best car list. So
okay.
Check out on Edmunds.com for that.
Maybe we'll talk again, and then I'll see what's in there. Thank you very much, James.
Thank you, gracias.
Thank you, gracias. Pues ahí tienen la lista de los 17 peores autos que pueden comprar acá en Estados Unidos. No necesariamente que sean malos por sí solos, sino que la competencia se los ha llevado por encima realmente de una manera muy obvia. Así que revisen la lista, la vamos a colocar en nuestra página de Facebook, facebook.com/auto060, para que la revisen. Y yo creo que van a estar de acuerdo con James Rizwick de Edmunds.com. Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos tenemos más aquí en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota.